Hello guys, so today we will continue with the remaining engine function string. We will complete all the functions which were pending or we haven't completed yesterday. So let's start with this. So very first function is we have, that is your join function. So this join function, right here, if you can see, we have a string twinkle twinkle little star. It is in form of list, and when we will execute this one, then we will find that it is putting tilde sign in between, and it is displaying the output. In the same way, we have another string, Albert Pindo ko ghusa kyun aata hai. And right here we are using cap sign, and then when you will run this one, it will replace all the spaces with cap sign, and then it will give you the output. Same for this Python programming right here. Now next one is ljust. So it is left justification and returns a left justified string of length. Good. So right here I have taken length as 18, and then I run this one. So this particular thing, that is Python programming, is fitted inside this. So you can have something else as well. Suppose I make it 180, so it will show you gap of remaining this one. Right here you can see this gap, and according to that it will give you the output. Okay, same in the second example, you can see that you have taken another string, and in that you are adding practice. Okay, now next one is lower, returns a copy of string convert to the lower case. So right here it is returning it into lower case. In the second one we have title case. So again, this title case is changed into lower case. Then we have lstrip. So lstrip returns a copy of string with leading white space. So right here you can see I have a string Python programming in which prefix with space and postfix with space, and when we run this one, it will ignore all the spaces in left side, and it will return the value. Same in the second example, woman, we have space in right and left both side, and we have this particular output. My next inbuilt function is translate. So this translate function, right here we have string as hello king, and we are replacing k by s. So it becomes hello sing. So this is my output. In the next one, you can see that we have Python programming. I am converting P to C, and it has become Python programming. My next inbuilt function is partition. So right here it is applying on this particular string, that is twinkle twinkle little star. And we have this particular weir partition.
Now, we have the next function, that is replace function. So this replace function replaces the value. So right here we have Python programming. So I am replacing Python with Java. So it is giving me Java programming. And in the same way, we have a string, I love my country. India is my country. So I am replacing country with nation. So it becomes India is my nation. Then we have something right find. Okay, so it finds value from right side. It has three total parameters. One is start and end, and on the basis of that it is giving me the output. Now right here I am finding location of this particular string, so it is returning me the index value. Then we have another function which is inbuilt function, that is rjustified. So right here I have I love Python programming. Now when you will run this one and I have given rjust as 80, so it is padding the value with space right here. You can see this particular thing. Next one is where we have Python programming and we are padding with 40. So whatever string length is there minus it will be subtracted from 40 and remaining will be my padded value, that is my blank values. My next function is rpartition. So again what we are doing right here is we are partitioning our string on the basis of the alphabet which the word which we have given right here. So right here you can see it is getting partitioned with Python, okay, and it is moving from right. Okay, it starts with programming, then it finds Python, then lib I. So in this way it is giving me partition on the from right side. Okay, so this is the output which we have. Now next one is rsplit. So this rsplit function right here you can see it is splitting on the basis of comma, and we have also picked up single space, and on the basis of that also we have split this particular string and it is converted into a list. Okay, now my next function is rstrip. Now my rstrip function, what it performs is it removes the blank space from right side. So like your left strip, L strip, it is right strip and it is removing space from right side. Then we have a common function which is split. So it splits the complete string and it gives you the output in the form of list. Now next one is start with. Now this start with function, it works like it checks the first alphabet, and on the basis of that first alphabet and first letter it identify whether it is starting with that or not, and then on the basis of it returns true or false. Now right here you can see that we have hello in smaller case. So for hello in smaller case, as Python is a case sensitive language, this capital hello and small hello both are different, so it is giving me output. Now right here what I am doing is I am saying hello, I am Alexa. So Alexa is on starting position 12 and onwards. So I am checking in that particular place. Okay. If I say like this, if I say only Alexa, the return, it will return false because it is not starting with that particular number. Index number. So right here I am mentioning the index number, and on the basis of that it is giving me the output. Same for the next one. Then we have another function which is called as strip. Now this strip function, it is just like your L strip, R strip. Now this particular will remove both side space from both side. So that is beauty of this particular function. Then we have swap case. So if we have something in uppercase, it converts it into lowercase. If it is in lowercase, then it will convert in uppercase. And right here I have taken a mixed string in which every alternate alphabet is capital and small. So on the basis of that, it is performing the operation. Then we have another function called as title function. So this particular title function, it works on the basis of it converts the string into title case. So right here you can see the output. I love Python programming, and it is converted into title case. Okay, and even it checks everything, and on the basis of that it converts it into title case. Now my second third last function is translate. So right here what it is doing is, from my value of s is 83 and value of 80 p is 80, capital P is 80, so it is converting on the basis of its ASCII value. So s is replaced by p, and we are getting the output right here. Next one is, we have something called as upper function. So upper function will convert it into uppercase. And then last one is my z fill. So it fills zero in place of wherever the space is available. So if my length is, right now Python programming, its length is 18 characters. So I have given 24. So 18 minus 24, so six places are there. So six places are filled with zero. So in this way, we have completed all the inbuilt function of Python programming, and specifically for data type string. Now, in the next video, we will see string indexing and string slicing, and that to be in depth with proper examples and proper stuff. And then gradually we will move to list and other data types, specifically data dictionary data type, data structure data type in Python programming. Okay, I hope you like this video, and please do subscribe this video and click on the like button, and we will connect.